Bill McClinton. So it's awkward. It's awkward. Now, there were some people who were being asked questions about all of this. So, for example, Tammy Duckworth, who was not picked as the vice presidential pick, she was asked about why Bill Clinton was speaking at the DNC. And she was like, well, it's a big tent. A big old rapey tent. So that's good stuff. And then we had Jennifer Granholm, the former governor of Michigan, explaining why Bill Clinton has not been canceled yet. And it got awkward because there is no good reason why Bill Clinton has not been canceled yet. Here was, this happened on CNN. Here was Jennifer Granholm trying to awkwardly explain why Captain Rapey McEpstein was up there on the DNC stage.
How is it that Bill Clinton has not been canceled by the Democratic? How has he survived all of these waves of cancellation when he has been one of the biggest violators of these rules in the Oval Office? Is that the right answer?
Okay, this has already been asked and answered decades ago. The point is that Bill Clinton is excellent at explaining stuff, especially the things that matter to everyday people.
What I admire about Bill Clinton is that he has acknowledged his wrongdoing.
He has acknowledged his wrongdoing? In what way? In what way has he acknowledged his wrongdoing exactly, Van Jones? And I love Jennifer Granholm. This happened a long time ago. Well, I don't know. Should we grab his high school yearbooks and ask him about boofing? I'm old enough to remember because I'm more than 2 years old when they asked Brett Kavanaugh what the devil's triangle was in his high school yearbook description. And he had to bring forth his calendars from high school, which was then seen as a mark of white supremacy and privilege. Yes, I'm old enough to remember all of that. But Bill Clinton, it happened a long time ago, guys. I mean, just because he was kind of like a little rapey, like a lot for like a lot of women, and there are dozens of allegations against him that are dicey. Come on, guys. Bill Clinton's still a good guy. I mean, it's a long time ago. I do love the Democratic changing standard. It's pretty astonishing. It really is pretty great. Okay, so then Bill Clinton gives his speech. And Bill Clinton is not looking as good as he did back in 2012. You'll remember that Bill Clinton gave this much ballyhooed speech at the 2012 Democratic National Convention on behalf of Barack Obama. Barack Obama came out and gave him a real awkward bro hug afterward. Okay, so last night, Bill Clinton gave his speech and he talked about why Donald Trump is not qualified to be president, the pressures of the job. And without any sense of irony or self-awareness at all, he started making references to the Oval Office. So here was Bill McClinton, Rapey McPlain-a-lot. Here he was.
At a time like this, the Oval Office should be a command center. Instead, it's a storm center. There's only chaos. Just one thing never changes: his determination to deny responsibility and shift the blame. The buck never stops there.
The Oval Office is a storm center. And the buck never stops with him. Okay, so when you're going to talk about using the Oval Office as a storm center, I don't think that Bill Clinton means it the same way that he thinks he means it. I mean, he was literally banging the interns in the Oval Office, guys. Like right there in the Oval Office. It got real awkward on that rug under the desk. So that was... Bill Clinton talking about the Oval Office at the DNC. Real, real weird. There was that. That was the thing that happened last night at the DNC. And then Bill Clinton was like, we can't trust Donald Trump because that man is not really... I do also like when he says, the buck always stops at the top. I mean, there are literal allegations that Bill Clinton was basically launching wars in order to avoid responsibility for nailing the help. Anyway, here's Bill Clinton talking about people being distracted at their jobs. He was like, we need people who are focused in like a laser beam on the job of being president of the United States. So here was Bill from Chappaqua. This is the first time he's been back to Chappaqua in years. I mean, he and Hillary Clinton studiously avoid each other. And they're like Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali, just despise one another, trying to stay away from each other, but locked in eternal combat. Here was Bill Clinton talking about defining the job of the presidency.
Denying, distracting, and demeaning works great if you're trying to entertain or inflame. But in a real crisis, it collapses like a house of cards. COVID just doesn't respond to any of that. To beat it, you've got to actually go to work and deal with the facts.
Right, we can't deny and we can't distract. We can't say, like, for example, that we didn't bang the help. We really can't say things like, there's a vast right-wing conspiracy to get me, and that is why it doesn't matter that I'm nailing the interns. Bill Clinton. And then he says that President Trump defines his job as tweeting, right? And you can't define the job as tweeting because that isn't the job. The job is definitely receiving oral sex in the Oval Office. I mean, that's the job, guys. And if anyone knows that, it's Bill Clinton. Here's Bill Clinton defining the job of the presidency.
Now you have to decide whether to renew his contract or hire someone else. If you want a president who defines the job as spending hours a day watching TV and zapping people on social media, he's your man.
And if you want somebody who spends hours a day checking out the thongs of the 18-year-olds who staff his office, we did that for two terms. So it seems like Americans have a kind of variegated view on the presidency. Okay, so they tried it out, Bill Clinton, so that was awkward. Did you know that every like on this video creates one additional leftist tier? Don't ask me why. That's called science. To take advantage of this amazing opportunity, hit the like button.